गुड आफ्टरनून गाइस, फाइन All of you know we can also use range command like this. All of you know the flavors of range command?
Yes, sir.
If you are not clear with the flavors of range command, please ask me. Fine? If you have any problem with the range command, please, you can ask. एक मिनट लुक हियर Done. Switch 1, switch 2, R1, R2, R3, R4. All the devices are there? What is IP on R1? IP on R2? R3? R4? VLAN 20. Clear? Now guys, look here. Interface, range, fast Ethernet 1/0/1, then fast Ethernet 1/0/2, then 1/0/20. What I have to do? No sure. Dikha sabko. What I have done, I have turned on three interfaces, 1, 2 and 21, 1, 2 and 21, clear?
Yes sir.
Dikha sabko?
Yes sir.
Maine turn on kar diya? Show run interface 1/0/1, look here, by default interface number 1 is at its default configuration, interface number 1 is at its 2,
default.
21.
Default.
Done. Now I am on switch 2. Interface range fast Ethernet. 0/3, 2, 4. Then which interface? 0/21. No shut. Done. Show interface FA0/. Show run interface FA0/3. Default. 21 default. Now you will say, sir, you are running one command, switch port more dynamic desirable. Guys, I told you that by default 3550 series switch have all the ports in which mode? But 3750 is having all the ports in dynamic auto. Clear? Now switches are giving me error, VTP domain mismatch. So what I will do, look here, VTP domain Cisco, here also VTP domain Cisco. Done. Now guys, look here, what is the command to verify VTP domain? Show VTP status. VTP domain name is VTP domain name is Cisco. Done. Now let me check the topology by running the command. Switch 1 is connected to, and other two devices are R1 and R2. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Switch 2 is connected to switch 1, and other two devices are R3 and R4. Topology is fine?
Yes, sir.
Let me show you the IP addresses.
ten dot one.
Clear? सबको समझ में आई इतनी बात? सबको?
Yes,
sir. So, guys, you can draw topology in your notebooks. This same topology with port numbers. Please be fast. Now, guys, look here. First of all, on switch 1, show interface trunk is the command to check any interface is trunk or not. And by default, what information we are getting? FA1/0/trunk. Oh, 21 is in which mode? Which mode?
Auto
means dynamic auto. It is negotiating which encapsulation?
ISL.
Status is trunking. Now, what is this native VLAN? Please leave it for some time. We will discuss the use of native VLAN when we will discuss about spanning tree. Because native VLAN was designed or was used or was, you can say, was came into play to make communication between common spanning tree and per VLAN spanning tree, to make that thing understood to you people. I will be discussing it at the time of spanning tree. Fine. Now, just this output is clear to all of you. Now, that's all. पहले इतना ही समझो, आगे चलते हैं. On switch 2, show interface trunk. Port number FA0/21. Mode is? Negotiating. Status is? Clear? It means this particular link is acting as trunk link. One side is dynamic auto, other side is dynamic desire. Clear? To all of you? Fine. It means VLAN 10 can communicate with VLAN 10 and VLAN 20 can communicate with VLAN
20.
Let me show you. So before sending traffic, let me configure the ports in desired VLAN. So first of all, let me create VLAN 10 and VLAN 20. I have created. Now interface fast Ethernet 1/0/1 switch port mode access. Switch port mode
access.
What this command will do? It will disable DTP on the port. It will disable DTP on the port. Clear? Switch port access VLAN. Spanning tree. Why I am running this command spanning tree port fast? All of you know by default a port will take around 30 seconds to come up. Agree?
Yes sir.
So we want to save our 30 seconds. That's why we are running this command. Again I am saying I will discuss this command at the time of spanning tree. Clear? Exit. Interface fast Ethernet 1/0/2 switch port mode access. Sorry. Switch port access VLAN 20 spanning tree done. Now I am on switch 2 VLAN either dekhna 10 and interface fast Ethernet. Spanning tree done. Ab dekho agar main jaldi, if I will do the configuration fastly, I will do it like this. Done. Fine. Now let me verify. Show VLAN brief. Port number 1 is member of VLAN. 2 is member of VLAN. Clear?
Yes, sir.
To all of you?
Yes, sir.
Port number 3 is member of VLAN. 20. 4 is member of VLAN. 20. Clear? Now. What command I am running?
VLAN.
I want to check VLAN 10 is associated with which ports? VLAN 10 is associated with which ports? So port number 1 I have manually assigned and it is also associated with port number
21.
Why?
Transport.
Because 21 is trunk port. 21 is
trunk port.
If you run the same command for VLAN 20 with port number 2, you have manually binded VLAN 20
yes.
and 21 because it is trunk port. Clear?
Yes.
To all of you?
Yes, sir.
All of you means? All of you. Sabka samajh mein aa raha?
Yes, sir.
Aaj phir balak kam aaya hai. Ya itne hi log hai?
Nahin.
Kam aaya na?
Nahin.
Itne hi log the. Pehle din to bahut zyada log the. Chalo. चल बात बात करें ठीक है जी. दिस थिंग इज क्लियर. शो VLAN ID 10. विच पोर्ट्स आर एसोसिएटेड विद VLAN 10? Why 21? It's a trunk port. It's cool. So let me try to ping 10.0.0.2. I'm able to ping?
Yes.
Ping. 20.0.0.2. We are able to ping?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
It means my trunk link is carrying traffic for VLAN 10 also and VLAN?
Also.
Clear? And which tagging method we are using? ISL.
ISL.
Which tagging method we are using?
ISL.
चलें भाई आगे. नाउ शो डीटीपी इंटरफेस फास्ट इथरनेट 0/20. ओके ब्रो. Which mode we are using?
Auto.
Encapsulation is?
Negotiate.
Fine. DTP is running. You can see here. Hello timer expiration, access timer expiration. What's written here? Running? Now, how many packets we have sent? How many packets we have received?
27.
Now, how many packets we have received?
28.
How many packets we have sent?
31.
Now, how many packets we have received?
29.
How many packets we have sent?
32.
It means dynamic auto will also send DTP packets after every. After every. And hold time is? Hold time is?
300 seconds.
Clear, guys?
Yes, sir.
To all of you?
Yes, sir.
Now, look here. Hanji? 26 अच्छे थे 26 were good 26 तो यहां गुड का मतलब ठीक है यार गुड का मतलब यहां भी अच्छा ही है वैसे ना छोड़ो ठीक है जी शो डीटीपी DTP packets are sent after every 30 seconds and hold time is 300 seconds. Next. Show interface fast Ethernet 1/0/21 switch port. Now guys, look here. Now guys, look here. What is my administrative mode by default? Dynamic?
Auto.
एक मिनट दे दो यार. Administrative mode क्या? Dynamic? Auto. Administrative means यार प्लीज बात मत करो मोड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव मोड का मतलब क्या है मोड कॉन्फिगर्ड बाय
एडमिन
व्हिच मोड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर हैज कॉन्फिगर्ड डायनेमिक ऑटो आफ्टर दैट हाउ पोर्ट इज ऑपरेटिंग हाउ पोर्ट इज Administrator has configured dynamic auto mode, but port is operating as trunk. There can be a chance in front of dynamic auto we have dynamic. Desirable. Here mode, which mode is configured? But port is configured operating as trunk. Why? Because trunk is negotiated. Trunk is? Samajh mein aaya? In dono mein difference. Yes, to anyone to whom difference is not clear. Administrative mode means the mode configured by administrator. Operational means how the port is operating. How the port is?
Operating.
Now, administrative trunking encapsulation. It is also by default.
Negotiate.
Which is negotiated?
ISL.
And on this port, DTP is on or off?
On.
This on is saying DTP is on. Clear? DTP is
on.
सबको समझ में आई इतनी बात है? Administrative mode का मतलब क्या? हमने कौन सा configure किया? Which mode we have configured? Operational means how the port is operating. Clear? The same thing goes with encapsulation also. After that, DTP is on or off?
On.
Look here, show CDP neighbor, Port number 21 is connected to switch 2.
Yes, sir.
But port number 1 and 2 are connected to the users.
Yes, sir.
Routers are connected, hai na?
Yes,
sir. We are treating here routers as users.
Yes,
show interface FA1/0/1 switch port. Read here. Administrative mode is?
Access.
What mode we have configured? Access. How port is operating?
Access.
Clear? And DTP is?
Off.
DTP is?
Off.
I told you, whenever we will configure a port as access, there will be no negotiation of trunking on that port. There will be no negotiation of trunking on that port. Clear?
Yes, sir.
To all of you? You can check it on port number 2 also. Negotiation of trunking is off. Clear? Now, do you want me to show you that how DTP will behave if on both the ends we will be having dynamic auto?
Yes, sir.
Kar loge aap ya dikhaun? Dekh lo. Aankhe khol lo. Interface FA0/21 switch port mode dynamic
auto.
Switch 1 is also dynamic auto, switch 2 is also dynamic
auto.
Do we have any trunk?
No.
Do we have any trunk?
No.
You can see here. My mode is? I am negotiating which? Encapsulation. How many packets are sent? How many packets are sent? Both sides are transmitting DTP packets, but trunk is never negotiated. Why? Because on both the ends we are running dynamic auto. Kitne packets ho gaye? Ho gaye? Theek hai ji? So on one side we have to configure dynamic designable. Clear? Interface fast ethernet 1/0/21 switch port mode dynamic. So this time this side will initiate trunking. Show interface. This side is trunk 21. Clear? Because this side is desirable. Show. And this side is auto. This side is auto. Clear? Ab dekho. Sorry. Administrative mode is? Operational mode is? Clear? Administrative mode is? Operational mode is? Clear? Thing is clear? Samajh mein aaya sabko? Now, what else we can do? We can configure static trunk also. Because I told you, whenever you will configure a port in static trunk mode, DTP will still remain on. That port will still negotiate. That port will still
negotiate.
Okay. On switch 1, we are running which mode? By default, desirable. Let me change it to auto. Sorry. On mode. Static trunk or on mode. 1/0/21. Switch port mode
trunk.
I will try to run this command, but switch will never let me run this command. Nahi chalne di? Kya keh raha hai? An interface whose trunk encapsulation is? Cannot be configured to trunk mode. Why? I told you, whenever you are configuring DTP, DTP is used to negotiate trunk. But before negotiating trunk, they will be negotiating encapsulation. This time on one side, you are manually configuring the port as trunk. So you have to define encapsulation because you are not giving time to the port to negotiate
एनकैप्सुलेशन, आप पोर्ट को एनकैप्सुलेशन को नेगोशिएट करने का कोई टाइम नहीं दे रहे, तो आपको एनकैप्सुलेशन पहले क्या करनी पड़ेगी, डिफाइन. क्लियर? सो व्हाट एनकैप्सुलेशन आई विल डिफाइन?
स्विच पोर्ट ट्रंक. व्हिच एनकैप्सुलेशन वी वांट टू यूज? लेट्स से स्विच पोर्ट मोड. डन. This side is statically configured as trunk. Show interface trunk. Mode is encapsulation. This side. Mode is, and it is negotiating dot one. It is negotiating dot one. Q. Clear to all of you? Fine.
Yes.
Next thing. Look here. Show interface. Here administrative mode is. Operational mode is. Administrative encapsulation is negotiated. Operational encapsulation is, and negotiation of trunking is still on. Look here. Mode is still acting as encapsulation. Configured is negotiated is, and negotiation of trunking is on. Clear? समझ में आया इतना? Now. Let me prove one more thing. You will check. Still DTP packets are sent. Earlier the number was 67. Now it is 60. अभी 69 भी हो जाएगा. अच्छा लग रहा है लिखा हुआ? फाइन. सो स्टिल डीटीपी पैकेट्स आर सेंट एंड ट्रंक इज नेगोशिएटेड. क्लियर? नाउ लेट्स से ऑन टू स्विचेस देयर इज वीटीपी डोमेन नेम मिसमैच. व्हाट इज मिसमैच्ड? वीटीपी डोमेन नेम. लेट्स से ऑन दिस स्विच वीटीपी डोमेन नेम इज VTP domain name is on this switch. VTP domain name is still I am having trunk. Now 62 packets are received. हाउ मेनी पैकेट्स आर बैड? आपको अगर याद हो पहले कितने पैकेट बैड लिखे हुए थे? तीन. बढ़ गया ना एक और. डोमेन नेम क्या हो रहा है? मिसमैच. शो हाउ मेनी पैकेट्स आर ड्रॉप्ड बिकॉज इन टू पैकेट्स व्हाट वाज द प्रॉब्लम? डोमेन नेम वाज. नाउ हाउ मेनी पैकेट्स आर ड्रॉप्ड? Because in three packets domain name was. What is the hold time? It means trunk will go down after 300 seconds. Trunk down चला जाएगा कितनी देर के बाद? After? It means it will wait for 10 DTP packets. How many DTP packets? 10. Clear? Why 10? 10 into 3. 10 into 30, sorry, 300. How many mismatches are there till now? So it will wait for 10 packets to mismatch. After that, it will remove the trunk. Now, what mistake people usually do? They expect trunk to be removed from switch 1. They expect trunk to be removed from But from switch 1, trunk will never get removed. Why? We have configured it statically. Clear? We have configured it statically. How many packets are mismatched?
5.
So just wait for one more 150 seconds. 10 packets are mismatched? वेट कर लो भाई, वो पहले एक आधा पैकेट और मिसमैच पड़ा होगा. ट्रंक इज रिमूव्ड आफ्टर वेटिंग फॉर हाउ मच टाइम? 300 सेकंड्स. बट ट्रंक विल नेवर गेट रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम स्विच 1. व्हाई? वी हैव कॉन्फिगर्ड हियर ट्रंक स्टैटिकली. यस, योर क्वेश्चन.
सर, विदाउट कॉन्फिगरिंग डीटीटी स्विचेस आल्सो वी कैन मेक डिसेबल ऑटो वी कैन फॉर्म ट्रंक.
विदाउट कॉन्फिगरिंग वीटीपी आल्सो यू कैन कॉन्फिगर ट्रंक. So there must be some reason. There is some reason that I can only explain when I will discuss about VTP. I can also do this thing, bro, that on two switches, VTP domain name is different. I can also form a trunk. I will disable DTP on both ends and I will form the trunk. If on two switches VTP domain name is different and it is your requirement that you want to form a trunk, just disable this fucking DTP on both the ends and configure static trunk. That's all. I'm again telling you something. Don't try to relate things on your level. At this time, you cannot relate VTP with DTP because we have not discussed VTP. Fine. Now, okay, I can give you a reason now also. All of you have studied VTP. The thing is, I don't know how much VTP you know. Okay, I think in the beginning I told you what is the use of VTP. All of you know VTP information is always shared between same domains.
Yes, sir.
VTP information is also always shared between
same domains.
Now, this is a requirement. I don't know you know or not. Whenever I want to send a VTP packet, I will only send VTP packet out of a trunk port.
Yes.
Out of a
trunk.
We will never send VTP packets out of access ports.
Yes.
A VTP packet kaun se port se send karte hain sirf trunk port se. So if two switches are having different VTP domain names, fine. One switch will send VTP packet to other switch, but other switch will drop it. Agree? If trunk will form, that's why DTP is not forming trunk. DTP trunk ki form hone nahi dega. Again, I am saying, I know these two switches have different VTP domain name and they will never share the information. Yes or no?
Yes.
So what DTP is doing? DTP is preventing this trunk. Otherwise, what will happen? This switch will be sending VTP message to this switch after every 300 seconds. After every 300 seconds, this is the time period of VTP message. So, वही बात थी. I don't know how much VTP you know. But there is a reason. Yes. That's why DTP is preventing the trunk. But if you want to form the trunk, you can form. Next thing. This thing is clear. Why trunk is not forming? So what I will do? Show VTP. VTP domain name. Let the other side send a DTP packet to switch 2. I'm getting again my trunk back. Clear? Trunk is formed because VTP domain name is same. Clear? Now, all of us know this side is and this side is static trunk, but still DTP is on. It means this side is negotiating, this side is clear. If I disable DTP on this end, what I will do? I will, this side will send DTP packets, but this side will not. This side will not negotiate. Clear? And this side will also stop sending DTP packets. Clear? So after 300 seconds, trunk will again go down. Clear? Go down chala jayega. Because we have disabled negotiation. We have disabled
negotiation.
Let me show you. Show. How many packets are received? 0 packets which are not negotiated. 0 packets are there which are not negotiated. So what I will do? Switch port. What this command will do? It will disable DTP on the port. Negotiation of trunking is? Everything is stopped. One packet is received which is not negotiated. Next thing, this side will stop sending DTP packets. Other side will not receive DTP packets from now. How many packets are received?
81.
It will not receive any more packets. Yeah, hamesha number 81 hi rahega. How many packets are received? How many are not negotiated?
Two.
So for how many packets it will wait? 10 packets. For how many packets it will wait? After waiting for 10 packets, trunk will be removed. Again, I am saying trunk will be removed only from switch 2, not from switch 1. Because on switch 1, you have configured trunk statically. Clear? Any DTP packet received on switch 2? No. Because other side will never transmit DTP packet. Other side will never transmit DTP packet. एक बात पूछूं, स्टिल डेटा इज सेंड, स्टिल डेटा कैन पास थ्रू दिस लिंक अप टू द टाइम ट्रंक इज अप वेदर पैरामीटर्स आर सेम और नॉट ट्रैफिक विल पास थ्रू दैट लिंक यू कैन सी है ट्रैफिक इज पास R1 is able to communicate with R3, not 2. R2 is in VLAN 20.
Yes, yes, yes.
Different VLAN communication we have not discussed. Done. Communication will still be there. So how many packets are received? 90 packets are received, 5 were not negotiated. Here you can see. Still, how many packets are received? Because the other side is not transmitting DTP. Because DTP is off. DTP is off. How many packets are not negotiated? Still, how many packets are received?
81.
Still data is passing. Clear? How many packets? जिसको डीटीपी पैकेट पहले रिसीव हो जाएगा यार। कितने हो गए पैकेट्स? क्रंकेस गॉन, यू कैन सी हियर, क्लियर? नो ट्रंक इज देयर, बट ऑन स्विच वन इट विल स्टिल शो। व्हाई? वी हैव कॉन्फिगर्ड हियर ट्रंक स्टैटिकली, क्लियर? नाउ गाइस, सेकंड थिंग, लाइक आई टोल्ड यू, लेट्स से ऑन टू स्विचेस वीटीपी डोमेन नेम इज डिफरेंट एंड यू वांट टू कॉन्फिगर देयर ट्रंक, व्हाट यू कैन डू ऑन बोथ ऑफ दैट एंड्स, यू कैन डिसेबल डीटीपी एंड यू कैन कॉन्फिगर ट्रंक स्टैटिकली। दिस थिंग यू कैन डू, कर लोगे इसको? ओके फाइन। नाउ दिस इज हाउ यू विल रिमूव दिस कमांड, लुक हियर ऑल ऑफ यू। ओए परी, क्यों बात कर रहा? हाँ देख, दिस इज हाउ यू विल रिमूव दिस कमांड, नो स्विच पोर्ट, नो नेगोशिएट, क्लियर? Now again DTP is on. DTP is on. Clear? Show interface trunk. Show interface trunk. Port is trunk. Agree?
Yes.
Everything is working fine. Now let me move to the next output. Show interface trunk. What is this thing? You can read this line. All, it means by default trunk port can add tag for all VLANs. By default trunk port can add tag for all VLANs. So look here guys, what's written here? VLAN allowed on? By default on this trunk port, or this trunk port can add tag for all the VLANs from 124094. From 124094. Clear? Read this line now. VLANs allowed and active in? Which VLANs are allowed? Plus show VLAN brief. Which VLANs are active guys? 110 and 20. These VLANs are also active, but these are not supported. These are not supported. Clear? So the only active VLANs left on the switch are 110 and 20. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Show interface trunk. VLANs allowed and active in management domain are 110 and 20. Clear? Sabko samajh mein aa raha hai?
Yes, sir.
And what is this? Yahi tak padhna. Leave this thing for now. VLANs is spanning tree forwarding state. All of you know what is spanning tree?
Yes, sir.
I think what you know about spanning tree, that spanning tree is a protocol which is used for loop prevention.
Yes.
But spanning tree is more than that. We will be discussing about spanning tree. But for now, how you can understand this output, that through this port, switch can send data for VLAN 1 also, 10 also, and 20 also. What do you mean by this output? Through
through this ports which can send data for
1, 10, and 20.
1, 10, and 20. Clear?
Yes, sir.
समझ में आई ये बात? अब वो क्यों है? Why switch is using this port for forwarding data? Or you can ask me how switch is using this port for forwarding data? That we will discuss at the time of expanding. Clear? Ping. We are able to communicate. Ping. We are able to communicate. Trunk port is sending data for VLAN 10 also and VLAN. Clear guys? You can see L10 also and 20 also. Let's say I want to modify this list. I want to. Now by default all VLANs are allowed on trunk. By default all VLANs are allowed on trunk. Let's say I want to modify this list. Yes, anyone? Who is asking anything? No. So how I will modify? Switch port trunk allowed VLAN. By default which command we are running? All. By default which command we are running? All. Clear? Now I will run the command 1, 10, and 20. It means this time I will be allowing how many VLANs?
3.
1, 10, and 20. Earlier how many VLANs were allowed? All. All means 1, 2, 4, 0, 9, 4. Exit. Show interface. How many VLANs are allowed on trunk this time? 1, 10, and 20. All are not allowed. Sorry. On this port, for which VLANs trunking is enabled?
1, 10, and 20.
Earlier?
All.
क्या लिखा था यहाँ पे?
All.
Fine. This output is clear. Next thing. Now, let's say to the current list you want to add one more VLAN. How many VLANs are there in the current list?
3.
1, 10, and 20. Let's say you want to add VLAN 30 also. So you can use this keyword, add 30. Done. One more VLAN is added, that is 30. Clear? So you know the meaning of this keyword? भाई ये कीवर्ड बता दिया आपको भाई देखो ये नहीं लिखा था अभी 1, 10, and क्या लिखा हुआ पढ़ो उसको ऑल ऑफ यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ एड कीवर्ड ऑल ऑफ यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ ऑल कीवर्ड ऑल ऑफ यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ नन इफ आई विल रन द कमांड नन मींस नो VLANs विल बी अलाउड क्लियर Now what is remove? Let's say you want to remove one VLAN from the list. Let's say I want to remove VLAN 30. Oye, kyun baat kar raha hai?
None karne par VLAN 30 allowed bhi hoga?
Koi bhi VLAN. Theek hai. This time which VLANs are allowed?
20.
What do you mean by accept? इसके अलावा accept this, all the VLANs will be allowed. Clear? Fine. Let's say from this list I am removing which VLAN?
10.
It means this trunk port cannot add tag for which VLAN?
10.
Show interface trunk. Look here. VLANs allowed on trunk 1 and
20.
VLANs allowed and active in management domain 1 and
20.
For which VLAN this port can forward data 1 and
20.
For which VLAN this port can forward data?
20.
1 and?
20.
But this time, user which is existing in which VLAN?
10.
10 is sending data. Switch has to add tag for VLAN 10. That's why switch is dropping data. Why? Because switch is not allowed to add tag for VLAN 10. As VLAN 10 is not allowed on the port. As VLAN 10 is? Let's say user from other end try to reach. This time my switch will receive data with tag of VLAN 10. देखो यार, एक तो आप ना समझते नहीं हो चीज को, जल्दी आपको कहा था डायग्राम बना लो. तो देयर वाज सम रीजन बिहाइंड इट. नाउ आई एम पिंगिंग फ्रॉम आर 3. कहां से पिंग कर रहा हूं मैं? दिस टाइम डेटा विल बी रिसीव्ड ऑन दिस पोर्ट विद टैग ऑफ VLAN 10 एंड दिस डेटा विल बी ड्रॉप बिकॉज स्विच 1 पोर्ट नंबर 21 विल नेवर अंडरस्टैंड VLAN 10 tag. Why VLAN 10 is not allowed? Clear?
Yes.
So this is how allowed VLANs will work. Fine. Clear? And this is how you can configure DTP. Any problems in understanding DTP? कोई दिक्कत हो किसी को DTP को समझने में?
Sir, we can also remove VLAN 1.
Bro, he has asked the same thing. Yes, you can.
But if you remember, so there is no need of adding a tag to the VLAN
number. See, yaar, मैंने आपको पहले कहा था, मैं native VLAN की बात अभी नहीं कर रहा. If you don't know the use of native VLAN, what you will do with untagged traffic? Just tell me one use of native VLAN. Why there is a need to send untagged traffic? Just give me one reason, I will explain you the whole thing.
So, suppose we have not configured a port to any VLAN.
Okay.
But also we can assign a IP to the PC, which is a default VLAN, and then we can communicate to the other PC.
Do you think your explanation is 1% logical? Think about it. There are two switches. You have not configured any VLAN. All ports are member of VLAN 1. So they can communicate with each other. What's the need of native VLAN? Again, I am asking. आपको किसी ने बताया था क्या? क्या लिखा हुआ है? पढ़ ले अभी. क्या लिखा हुआ है? फिर जब वन नहीं है तो नहीं है ना अलाउड. वही मैं कह रहा था यार, हिंदी में बता रहा था, करके दिखाना पड़ा तुम्हें. यू डोंट नो हिंदी? थोड़ा तेज बोला करो ना यार. भाई मैं ये कह रहा था, जब तुम ट्रंक फॉर्म करते हैं दो स्विचेस, तो उनके बीच में पहले एनकैप्सुलेशन नेगोशिएट होती है, फिर ट्रंक बनता है. तो उन्हें पता है ना कौन सी एनकैप्सुलेशन यूज करनी है. तुमने एक पोर्ट को स्टैटिकली ट्रंक बनाया, क्या तुमने उस पोर्ट को बताया कौन सी एनकैप्सुलेशन यूज करनी है? नहीं. तो तुम्हें उस पोर्ट को पहले क्या बताना पड़ेगा, कौन सी एनकैप्सुलेशन यूज करनी है.
तो ऑटो डिजायरेबल में
ऑटो और डिजायरेबल में वो नेगोशिएट करते हैं ना ट्रंक को, और स्टैटिक में तुम पोर्ट को मैनुअली क्या बनाते हो, ट्रंक। अब नेगोशिएट करने का मतलब आप में से कितने लोगों को समझ में आया, हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू नो व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय नेगोशिएशन। नेगोशिएशन का मतलब होता है जो ट्रंक का मैसेज आएगा ना दोनों स्विचेस पे, वो एट द सेम टाइम आएगा, ट्रंक बन गया, और जब स्टैटिक बनाऊंगा तो मेरे एंड पे पहले आ जाएगा, सामने वाले एंड पे जब बनाऊंगा तब आएगा। ये मतलब होता है नेगोशिएट करने का। स्टैटिक ट्रंक इज द प्रेफर्ड वे, वी ऑलवेज कॉन्फिगर पोर्ट इन स्टैटिक ट्रंक मोड, वी नेवर यूज डीटीपी, वी नेवर रिलाई ऑन डीटीपी, एंड वी यूज टू डिसेबल डीटीपी ऑन द पोर्ट जस्ट टू डिक्रीज द अमाउंट ऑफ कंट्रोल प्लेन ट्रैफिक इन रियल टाइम नेटवर्क्स। यस, एंड इन रियल टाइम नेटवर्क्स व्हाट इज रिकमेंडेड, प्लीज क्रिएट लेस नंबर ऑफ VLANs एज यू कैन। ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, यू आर द पीपल हु आर स्टडिंग टेक्नोलॉजी, नॉट एवरी वन इज सो अवेयर विद टेक्नोलॉजी, नॉट एवरी वन नो दैट हाउ दीज VLANs विल कम्युनिकेट, वेयर दिस VLAN इंफॉर्मेशन विल बी स्टोर्ड। सो द पर्सन हु आर वर्किंग इन कंपनी, they have just 10-20% knowledge of technology, so they try to make things very simple, because at the time of troubleshooting they have to do troubleshooting in desired amount of time. That's why they, let's say I have 1000 users and I have 50 switches and I have to deploy a network, I will use only a single VLAN. Yes, this is how real time scenarios are built. It will not be like this that in that case I will be building 50 VLANs flana dimkana, no, I will keep it very simple. Yes, now dot 1q encapsulation also supports untagged data. There is a concept of native VLAN in case of .1Q. Again, I am saying, I will not discuss the use of .1Q. Sorry, native VLAN. I am just discussing how it will work. Again, I am saying. So, native VLAN, concept of native VLAN is only present for .1Q encapsulation, not for not for ISL. Now look here, by default VLAN 1 is native. Which VLAN is native? VLAN 1. Next thing, VLAN 1 data is sent from which port?
Trunk port.
Next thing, whenever a port will receive untagged data, switch think it belongs to which VLAN? Native VLAN. So whenever switch has to send data for native VLAN, it will send it as untagged. Whenever switch will receive untagged data, what it will think? It belongs to native VLAN. Sabko samajh mein aaya? This thing is clear to all of you? Whenever switch has to send data which belongs to native VLAN, switch will send untagged data. Second thing, whenever switch will receive untagged data, it will think it belongs to native VLAN. Clear? Last point about native VLAN. Native VLAN must match on both ends of trunk line. Native VLAN must match on both ends of trunk length. Clear? Look here. How many VLANs are allowed on trunk this time? Show interface. You can see here all VLANs are allowed on trunk. Now look here. Let's say this side I am configuring native VLAN. So on the other side of trunk also we have to configure native VLAN. Native VLAN. देखो यार एरर भी किसका आता है विच प्रोटोकॉल इज गिविंग मी एरर व्हेन आई एम डूइंग सम चेंज विद विच VLAN इट मींस नेटिव VLAN इज रिलेटेड टू दैट्स व्हाई आई वाज सेइंग नेटिव VLAN इज Native VLAN is done. Done. Now, whenever user 1 will send traffic for 10.0.0.2, how switch 1 will be sending it? Tagged or untagged?
Untagged.
Tagged or untagged?
Untagged.
Why? Because VLAN 10 is native. Clear? To all of you.
Sir, जब आपने VLAN all कर दिया था, अभी VLAN all कर दिया था सबको, तो सर forwarding spanning tree में सर कुछ भी नहीं दिखा रहा
था। यार अब मैंने आपको बताया ना, मैं हर चीज अभी आपको justify नहीं कर सकता। जब मैं spanning tree पढ़ाऊँगा, वो spanning tree से related है ना हर चीज। मैंने आपको सिर्फ उसका मतलब बता के छोड़ दिया यार। उसका मतलब क्या होता है कि ये पर्टिकुलर पोर्ट किस किस VLAN के लिए डेटा सेंड कर सकता है आपको पता होनी चाहिए यार इतनी बात कि स्पैनिंग ट्री कन्वर्जेंस में 30 सेकंड लगते हैं स्पैनिंग ट्री विल टेक 30 सेकंड्स टू कन्वर्ज सो इट इज इट वाज टेकिंग इट्स टाइम अपने आप आ जाए बता दिया यार जो बताना था बोला तो यार अभी नहीं बता सकता कैसे बता दूं See, again I am saying one thing. If you want to discuss these small, small, shitty things, start reading your book. Again I am saying. The thing is, you have not studied your CCNA book thoroughly. That's why you have these kinds of questions. Yes. You want to ask?
Yes. VLAN 20
it's pinging. How you can say it's not pinging?
It's native so untagged VLAN convert to the VLAN.
Native VLAN means on that port for that particular VLAN traffic will be sent untagged. Remaining VLANs will be sent tagged. Yes. Look here. 20.1 is able to communicate with 20.2. This traffic is sent as tagged. But traffic for VLAN 10 is sent as untagged. Switch 1. Now I have a question. This port belongs to VLAN 10. This port is trunk port. Here I have a user, here I have a server. IP is 10.1, IP is 10.2. My question is, can this user access this server. If yes, then how? If no, then यार देख यार इसमें मेरे को एक चीज बता क्या लग रहा है तुझे बताने वाला
इधर वाले में कौन सा लिखा
भाई ट्रंक पोर्ट लिख रखा है यार
किस वाले में वीलन पोर्ट
है भाई ट्रंक पोर्ट है ट्रंक पोर्ट इज नेवर मेंबर ऑफ एनी पर्टिकुलर वीलन अगेन आई एम सेइंग इफ यस देन हाउ इफ नो देन व्हाट
इट्स कंसीडर्ड इट्स द होस्ट
This is our interview question. A server is connected here. Both are routers. I am telnetting this router. Take it like this. I want a reason. I don't want yes or no. I can prove both of the things. It will not ping. Both are in different VLAN.
Yeah, no, it will not ping. Because the trunk will take native VLANs.
Good.
So it must be in VLAN 1, 10.2.
So he got the thing. Anyone? Koi aur batana chahe? Anyone else want to discuss?
The server is in open native VLAN, like VLAN 1 default VLAN.
See guys, what will happen? Try to use your basic thing. Again I am saying, let's say 10.1 want to communicate with 10.2. So what 10.1 will do? 10.1 will generate ARP. It will be received by switch.
Yes.
Now switch will check, this port belongs to VLAN
10.
So this particular ARP packet will be forwarded on all the ports that belong to VLAN
10.
Trunk port is member of all VLANs. Clear? So it will tag ARP packet with VLAN 10. It will forward it to the server. Now server will never read this tag. Server will only read ARP request and server will give a ARP reply. When ARP reply is received on this trunk port, reply is received as
untagged
because server don't know anything about tagging. Clear? So server will think this particular ARP reply belongs to which VLAN? Native VLAN is VLAN 1. So server will try to send this packet on which port? The port which belongs to VLAN
1.
But my user is connected in which VLAN?
10.
It means they will not communicate. And all of you know the reason why?
Yes, sir.
Now, let's say I want to give you answer. Yes. Yes, they will communicate. But on this port, you have to configure native VLAN as
10.
On the trunk port, we have to configure native VLAN as
10.
Only then they will
communicate.
Either change VLAN of this user to
1.
But that will change the question. That will change the question. So exact answer will be change native VLAN on the port to 10. Clear?
Yes, sir.
You got the answer? So answer can be no also answer can be
yes
also. If you know it's no, only then you can make it
yes.
Keep this thing in mind. अगर आपको पता है ये answer no है, तभी आप इसको क्या बना सकते हो?
Yes.
अगर नहीं पता, फिर नहीं बना सकते. It's not possible. Any doubts in this case?
No,
so, concept it somehow clear that what is native VLAN? Traffic for native VLAN will be sent
untagged.
Whenever switch will receive untagged traffic, it means that traffic belongs to
native VLAN.
Switch will think it like this. Switch will think it like this. And I am saying native VLAN is something which is related to spanning tree. Okay, let me try to tell you a part of it. All of you know what kind of BPDU CST was sending untagged. You remember? नहीं पढ़ा ऐसा कुछ? नहीं पढ़ा? Bridge ITR. वो किसी काम की नहीं है ओके इन केस ऑफ सी एस टी देयर वॉज ओनली वन इंस्टेंस यू नो वन रूट ब्रिज वॉज इलेक्टेड इन केस ऑफ पीवीएसटी मल्टीपल रूट ब्रिजेस आर इलेक्टेड ओके आई विल एक्सप्लेन व्हेन आई विल डिस्कस
spanning tree. Leave it here. One more thing, homework for all of you. In case of ISL, write it down. In case of ISL, native VLAN is not used. So what will happen? Happen if untagged traffic is received in case of ISL, native VLAN is not used. What will happen if untagged traffic is received on on a port running ISL. Question is clear?
Yes.
All of us know ISL will never support native VLAN. ISL will never support native VLAN. So whenever on a port on which you are running ISL encapsulation will receive untagged traffic, it will drop the traffic. Write down the answer also. It will drop the traffic. Always keep this thing in mind.
It will drop the traffic.
अरे
ये हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू नो अबाउट मैक्रो नो मैक्रो मोनेको मोनेको Look here, guys. Let's say you want to configure some interfaces on the switch. What do you want to do? You want to configure some interfaces. Let's say your interface numbers are
दस मिनट
नहीं सर प्लीज बोल दो मिनट लगे सर घड़ी देख के
लेट्स से यू हैव दीस पोर्ट्स एंड यू वांट टू डू सम कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ऑन दीस पोर्ट्स सो व्हाट यू विल डू ऑल ऑफ यू नो द रेंज कमांड सो लेट्स से
यू हैव टू डू कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ऑन दीस पोर्ट्स लाइक 10 टाइम्स इन अ डे सो यू हैव टू कॉल अ बिग रेंज कमांड ऑलवेज क्लियर You have to write or you have to type a big range command always. You always have to write a big range command.
Yes.
So, what we can do to prevent this thing? We can define a range of interfaces and place it in a macro. Instead of calling all interfaces again and again, I will call my
macro.
I will call my
macro.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
So, it is like this.
Interface range. Macro, name of macro. Just tell me one name, Pari. Fast Ethernet 1/0/1 to 4. Fast Ethernet 1/0/10 to 11. Like this, you can define macro. What was the command? This was the command to define macro. Let's say you want to do now configuration on these ports. Just do one thing. That's all. You don't have to call all interface numbers again and again. Clear? This is the use of macro. Clear, guys? Any problem? To anyone? No. Pakka? Now, next thing, I told you about SVI, switch virtual interface, switch virtual interface. Clear? Why we create SVI on a switch? To access it remotely. Next thing, what is SVI? Look here. By default, let's say this is a switch. There are two users. One is having IP 10.1, other is having IP 10.2. Both belongs to VLAN 10. So if I want to access this switch from these users, I will be creating SVI for which VLAN? For VLAN 10. If you remember, I told you we always have to create SVI for same VLAN. We always have to create SVI for same VLAN. Clear? Any problem? No. Let's say what IP I am assigning. 10.100. Clear? Now guys, switch will treat, just to make you understand, I am saying these words. Switch will treat SVI also as a connected user, but not physically. Clear? Switch will also treat SVI as a connected user, but logically, not physically. Yes. Dear, if you remember, after creating SVI on the switch, we were able to access that IP. Yes, it means we can ping that IP. We can ping that IP, clear? So switch will consider this SVI as a connected user, but not
physically,
but logically. Now, when you will create a SVI, switch will also give a MAC to this SVI. Switch isko kya dega ek? MAC. Clear? To all of you? To all of you means all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, SVI ko hum loopback ke saath ko relate kar sakte
hain? Nahin. My user is in VLAN 10. Let's say I want to create SVI for which VLAN? 10. Interface VLAN 10. IP address 10.0.255.0.0. No, shut up. I have created SVI.
Yes, sir.
Show interface VLAN 10 include. Switch has assigned a MAC address to this particular interface? Switch has provided to this virtual interface, yes or no?
Yes.
Clear?
Yes.
Now, how switch will treat it? Switch will treat it like this, that a user is connected whose IP is 10.100 and MAC also switch has provided. Which MAC? 53C1. Clear? Let's say 10.1, whose MAC address is A, want to communicate with 10.100. What it will do? It will generate a ARP. ARP will be received by switch. What switch will do? Switch will forward this ARP packet to all the ports which are member of VLAN. Plus to this logical interface also. So this logical interface will receive the ARP. It will reply with its MAC address. Now, whenever this user will forward data to this particular IP, what will be the destination MAC? 53C1. Now the problem is, when switch will receive the packet on its interface,
Switch will check destination MAC for forwarding it. Switch will never find destination MAC in its MAC address table. In its MAC address table. All of you know the reason why. How switch will form MAC address table with the help of source MAC. Agree? Whenever any user will hit the switch, only then switch will be able to learn source MAC. जब भी कोई यूजर स्विच को क्या करेगा, ट्रैफिक सेंड करेगा, तभी स्विच क्या लर्न करेगा, सोर्स मैक. दिस यूजर कैन नेवर सेंड ट्रैफिक टू द स्विच बिकॉज दिस यूजर इज अ लॉजिकल यूजर. सो इट्स मैक एड्रेस इज नेवर प्रेजेंट इन मैक एड्रेस टेबल. सो दिस इज अ रूल बाय डिफॉल्ट. व्हेनेवर अ स्विच विल रिसीव ट्रैफिक ऑन एनी इंटरफेस, इट विल चेक मैक एड्रेस टेबल प्लस आर टेबल प्लस Switch will check this traffic is for it or it has to forward it. It has to forward it. Let me show you. Now, let's set from 10.1. From 10.1, I want to ping 10.0.0.100. I am able to ping? Nahi. I am able to ping? Yes or no?
Yes.
I have MAC address of the user also. 53C1?
Yes.
53C1. Check. Show MAC address table. Address. Do this MAC address is learned on any port?
No.
No. But this MAC address will be present in ARP table. So whenever switch will receive traffic on any of the interface, it will check two tables. One is second is MAC table. First is ARP table, just to check whether this traffic belongs to a directly connected SVI or not. क्या check करने के लिए कहीं traffic मेरे ही SVI के लिए तो नहीं है. देखो यार दो चीजें होंगी. When someone is knocking your door, there will be two things. Either he is lost or he has reached to the correct destination. आप किसी ने आपका दरवाजा खटखटाया तो मैं कैसे समझूंगा. एक तो ना सेंस ऑफ ह्यूमर भी अलग हो जाता है ना, लैंग्वेज डिफरेंट हो जाती है तो लोगों की. यस दिस इज द थिंग आई कैन नॉट एक्सप्लेन. सी व्हाट आई वाज ट्राइंग टू टेल यू, व्हेन समवन इज नॉकिंग एट योर डोर देयर विल बी टू थिंग्स, आइदर ही इज लॉस्ट और ही हैज रीच्ड करेक्ट डेस्टिनेशन. फाइन. Now, whenever switch will receive the traffic, there will be two things. Either traffic is for switch or switch has to forward the traffic. Now, just to check traffic is for switch or not, switch is checking which table? R table. And to forward the traffic, it is checking which table? MAC address. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So, whenever switch will receive the traffic, how many tables it will check always? R table and
MAC address.
Why it is checking R table? Just to confirm this thing, traffic is not for it. Traffic is not for it.
Yes.
Clear? This thing is fine.
Yes, sir.
So whenever you create a SVI on a switch, first thing switch will do, switch will provide a MAC address to that SVI. Second thing, switch will make an entry in its ARP table that this IP is having this MAC. This IP is having this
MAC.
Clear?
Yes.
And this rule is by default, like I told you, whenever switch will receive the traffic, it will check how many tables?
Two tables.
R table and
MAC
table. MAC table for forwarding purpose and R table to check if traffic is for it or not. Clear? So guys, the things we have discussed today, you have to revise it. Tomorrow we will start with VTP. Today is Wednesday. 2 days are left.